morning. I have woken up in Torridon today, and it is absolutely beautiful. The sunrise is incredible. This is where I stayed last night. I've had the most brilliant few days here in Torridon. I've been out on my bike, I've been on a few runs, and I even got myself a shower yesterday. I got the shower curtain out here. I got to wash my hair and went in a lock before. And getting up for sunrises like this is just worth everything. It is incredible. The mountains are illuminating with the sun and it is just beautiful. But anyway, I've come outside because I'm recently doing a course. It's a Vivo Barefoot course and it's called Human Potential. And it's on everything that sort of makes you a better person, as in your well-being and your health and being connected to yourself. And the first topic's about light, and it says how the blue light in the morning that I'm experiencing right now can set off melatonin in your body. So in 14 hours my body clock inside me will feel groggy and tired, so it'll enable me to feel sleepy and want to go to bed. And I think that's amazing how you've got a built-in body clock by the light. It comes in on your retina, like your lower retina. It's crazy how the light in the morning sets off something in your body, and it's called a circadian, I think it is, which is approximately day that's in your body, and it sets off this hormone in your pineal gland, and I find that amazing. So that's why I've come out today, to just sort of experiment it, and also because it's absolutely beautiful. Such a lovely morning. I cannot believe the weather. I was literally speaking to someone just then and saying it feels like spring. Like the weather is insane. Bright blue skies, not a cloud in the sky, and the sun shining, and actually you can feel heat off the sun, and the snow starting to melt on the tops, and it's just, it's incredible. It really is incredible. I've stayed at this spot for two nights as I just wanted to get some stuff sorted. And I also had a big day of exercise. I did a long run and a bike ride yesterday. So it was pretty strenuous, and I definitely feel it on my legs today, very achy. And now I'm regretting it, because it would be an amazing day to do a Monroe, because a lot of the snow's melted, so there isn't loads of snow to deal with. And the weather is incredible. And it's just, I got slight regrets. I've also got to edit a video, so work's got to come before mountain sometimes. I guess you got to draw a line somewhere, but this would be such a perfect day, and I really wish I was up there, but is what it is, I guess. Last night was something else. I came out and the moon was so bright. It was a full moon and it was amazing. It was lighting up everywhere, and it looked like the mountains were luminous, like they were glow in the dark, and it was just, it was amazing. The snow on the tops was illuminating, and it just lit up the whole landscape, and it was incredible. So moments like that are really special. And this morning, the sunrise was crazy. I woke up, I was feeling a little bit slow and sluggish as I had a long day yesterday, and I just saw this beam of orange coming through the window. So I dashed out and wanted to see it. And obviously talking about the blue light as well, how amazing that is for your body and to sort of set your body clock. So it's an amazing course what I'm doing. I'm really getting into it. And it's just nice to sort of improve your well-being and be more of an all-round person with all your sort of health with your body, just understanding your body more and understanding how aligned it is with the planet is really amazing. I'm actually nearing the end of my trip, which makes me really sad. It's a shame. I've got a sort of deadline on this trip. I've got to get down south to do a work week, well, a full 2 work weeks for something, and I need to get back, and it's such a shame. I'm so gutted. It's just, this is my last day in the Torridon area. Tonight I'll be heading over to Applecross and doing Balaknabar. I'm probably camping up there. And then after that, I've got 2 days that I'm hoping to spend on Skye if everything works out well, and spend just 2 days touring around Isle of Skye, then a night in Glencoe, and then head into the Lake District for a week, and then back down to do the work bits. But I wish I had longer up here. I really do, because when it's days like this, it's just, you don't want to leave. And I've had such an amazing time. And the Norcoast 500, I really underestimated it. And I thought it'd be really busy. I thought it'd be really touristy. I thought it'd ruin the whole wild feeling Scotland gives. And it didn't do that in the slightest. It was amazing. And I loved it. And it's been beautiful. And I've explored so many new things. I also revisited old things that I've loved and really learned a lot, like I always do. You always do when you go on trips alone, and I think that's really precious. But anyway, I am going to hopefully try and fit in an hour. So whether it is just walking halfway up this Monroe, which does seem a little bit pointless because I know when I get halfway I want to go to the top. Either way, I really want to just move my body a bit because I know I'll be super achy. And get on with some work bits. Today's definitely not the day to sit on a laptop, but got to get videos out, so that is the plan. And then I will be heading over to Applecross, like I said. They're meant to have the best fish and chips, so I might treat myself tonight and then camp up Balaknabar, which is a big pass that goes through the mountains that obviously leads to Applecross, and then see how we get on. I'm just going up the path that leads to this Monroe that is absolutely gorgeous, and I have deep regrets for not doing it today. I really wish I planned on coming up here today. It's now 12, so it's too late, and I've got a heap of work to do, which I was actually contemplating a minute ago and thinking, sod it, should I just leave it and upload a bit later and do this instead. Right, so we're all packed up as you can see, and I'm thinking of heading over to Applecross right now. So I've got a bit of work done. I got out on a walk, which felt lovely, and it's still a beautiful day, so I thought it's a perfect time to travel over to Applecross and potentially Balaknabar, see how the time goes, and find a nice spot for tonight to set up. Your soul. So I've just got to my spot for tonight, and oh my gosh, it's so beautiful. It overlooks the sea. It's beautiful. It's just 5 minutes up Blacknabar, so it's not that far, and I didn't really get into the climb, but gained a bit of height to overlook the sea like this, because I was just down here really in Applecross, and I went to the pub and I got the best food ever. I was meant to get fish and chips, like I said, just because I wanted to be sort of like traditional, but they were doing a roast, a Sunday roast, so I thought, oh, that's really, really what I'm feeling. So I got that and it was amazing. I am now in my humble abode. I have set up everything. I went for a quick walk just to sort of digest that roast. And so I just went for a walk down this track that I'm parked near, and a potential recce for tomorrow's run before I head off again. And just all cozy. Got my fairy lights up. I've got the diesel heater on and just sorting out, making it all nice and tidy and livable. Today we are heading to Isle of Skye, which is mega, which is so cool. I've just done a morning 5k run and I've just got myself ready, and we are going to be driving up Blacknabar, back down Blacknabar, and we've got about just under 2 hours to get to where I want to on Isle of Skye. But it's the most beautiful day. I'm hoping to get lots of drone footage, some beautiful shots. Tomorrow's meant to be awful, like heavy rain, so we're just gonna see how we get on and go with the flow and just enjoy the trip, enjoy the time on Isle of Skye while the weather is amazing. Right, so we have just started the real incline for Blacknabar. Percy's still warming up, so I don't want to go too ham because he hasn't got up to temperature yet, but already it just shows you how high this road goes, because there's snow up here. You can see the snow, it's amazing. This is awesome. This is so beautiful. I saw a guy who was snow ploughing and salt spreading this morning when I was down there, but I didn't realise there would be this much snow up here on the pass. It's actually quite a bit. Right, so I've been driving for a little while and I am now near the Carle of Lochish, which actually is the bridge that links mainland Scotland to Isle of Skye, which is that beautiful island that I'll be visiting over the next couple of days to see how I get on, but I'm so excited. I am now in Isle of Skye and it is beautiful. What a warm and lovely day. The sun feels amazing on my skin. It feels like I haven't felt the sun in so long. Oh, it's wonderful. It feels so good to be here, and I'm getting very strong Vancouver Island vibes. It just feels like Vancouver Island in Canada for some reason. I think it's the trees, the road, the sea, just a bit of everything. It's a very strange feeling. Good evening. I'm at my first spot in Isle of Skye that I'm going to be staying, and it is so windy. I don't know if you'll hear it during me talking, but the wind is really, really bad, like crazy. I'm right on the coast, so that's probably affecting it. But I'm having my dinner, I've got burgers tonight, something pretty quick and simple to make because I got here quite late. I drove till late, really, and then recce'd a walk that I want to do tomorrow up to the Old Manor store. Good morning. I would say I slept really well, like I normally start every morning and say that, but I really didn't. It was so windy. It is extremely windy out there, like really badly windy. I couldn't really push the back door to get out this morning. It was quite funny. But as you can see, this park up was amazing last night, right off the road, and I wasn't disturbed, and I've left no trace. I had a rubbish bin that was tied up, luckily, under the landy last night, because I didn't want to keep the rubbish inside while I sleep. It was all across this hillside, the bag, not all the rubbish, the bag had like flown across the hillside, gone down. I was right next to the road, and I just did the walk of shame this morning and went and fetched it. Luckily it was tied up, because there would have just been rubbish everywhere, and it took me ages to clear it all up, but that got picked up. It's back in the landy now. So yeah, just leaving no trace. I just have constant guilt that I'd always left that bag there. I just couldn't live with myself, and I don't know how people can leave such a mess in places. It's crazy. I just respect this place too much to want to leave it really nasty. But anyway, rant over. Let's go and do some cool walks. Let's go and see if we can see the Old Man of Store, and I'll potentially tell you the story behind it on a voiceover. I love sharing my trips in Scotland and enabling people from all over the world to see the beauty Scotland has to offer. But if you do decide to visit Scotland, please abide by the Leave No Trace policy and leave Scotland wild. But anyway, this morning I headed over to the Old Man of Store, so I'll share a little backstory of it now. First off, Skye is the largest and most northerly of the Inner Hebrides. It is 50 miles long and has a population of 13,000. It's believed to have more sheep than people. Skye was occupied in prehistoric times and settled by Gaelic-speaking Scots from Ireland. Norsemen ruled the island from the 9th to the 12th century.
About that walk, hailstones.
Right, I don't know what to do now.
I really wish I'd just sent it last night. It is super windy and there's hail. Shall I go or shall I not go is the question. There's like bollards sliding around on the road, it's that windy.
I don't know what to do. I'll think about it. I just don't see the point now because I'm not going to really see the old man of store in these conditions. Which is really disappointing because I really, really, really wanted to do the walk and see it. It's a big attraction for coming to Skye because it's just a beautiful piece of rock that's coming out of the ground. And the walk looks pretty nice. It's a pretty easy walk. It's all on a paved track up to it. So I've decided to make my way up there. The weather is so on and off. Rain's coming in now. Whew. It's got a very ominous, godly sort of feeling here. It's very, very special. And it almost feels like a very spiritual place. I'm up here on my own, so you're getting a whole different experience if there was loads of tourists, but it is wonderful.
The Old Man of Store is believed to be a remnant of the volcanic activity that forged the Isle of Skye around 2,800 million years ago. Other than that, it's mostly myths and folklore surmising about this incredible rock formation, believing it was once a giant that roamed the hills.
So I'm now returning back to the car, gonna descend this lovely walk. It has been beautiful. It is so, so beautiful. I'm so glad I made the trip up. I'm gonna head back as quick as possible before the next hail shower comes in. Right, so I've got back down and I am going to be heading off again. So we're going to be heading on to another cool destination, which is Coral Beach. It looks like a beautiful beach and the weather's actually cleared up, so we might get some nice conditions. But yeah, that walk was incredible. Really, really enjoyed it. coral beach, which should be really lovely. And it's sort of made up of loads of tiny seashells. It's really beautiful. I've seen photos of it and I've just read about it. It's basically skeletons of this red seaweed, and it's sort of evolved over years and years. I've just got to my park up.
I am extremely tired, really tired today. I think it's because it's just been really overwhelming with a lot of beauty and a lot of travelling and speaking to lots of different people. And the time now is 7:15. So yeah, like I said, I've just got to my park up. It's a simple spot. It's like a sort of gravel lay-by that's off a single track road that feels like it's in the middle of nowhere, so it's so quiet. I've set up Percy a lot better tonight in terms of the wind. There's a nice spot just behind me where it can like go right off and up, if that makes sense. I'll show you tomorrow, but yeah, you can drive a little way up and you're on like a bit of a platform, and it's a much nicer spot, like I say, but I'm going to have the same drama with the wind. So I've put my nose into the wind tonight, so that will definitely help. But yeah, in a beautiful location, there's clear skies, which is crazy. I was not expecting that from tonight. And I've just got the silhouettes of the hills, and it's lovely. I'm right next to the sea as well. I haven't really planned tomorrow yet. It was just going to be based off the weather, what to do. And what I've seen so far is it's going to be absolutely torrential rain. I haven't checked since because there's no signal here. So I obviously won't find out until tomorrow. And that's the truest form of weather, actually experiencing it instead of seeing it on a screen sometimes. But yeah, I'll just see how it goes. I really want to visit the fairy pools. That's something I really want to see again. And I'll have a look, see other bits and bobs, some hikes or some cool stuff to see that's sort of low level if it's going to be absolute torrential rain. And yeah, but for now, I'm going to get some food on. I'm going to chill. I think I'm going to have an early one because I'm feeling very tired today. I've just got to the car park of Fairy Pools and it's happened again. It's raining and it's so clagged over. I wouldn't even mind if it was raining. It's the fact you can barely see anything, that's just thick cloud. So I don't know if I'm going to bother going over there. When I looked down the path, there was just quite a few people. So you won't get the same experience. So I don't know if I'm going to bother. Plus it's £6 just to walk there and walk back to leave your car in this car park. So, So because of the clagged out weather and the torrential rain, I decided to give it a miss this time. But if you're not sure what the fairy pools are, they are a series of natural pools and waterfalls that create this beautiful hotspot that people love to walk, swim, and take photos of.
Good evening. I'm now in Fort William. So I ended up leaving Skye and I was really upset about that. I just didn't want to leave. The weather was awful though. It still is really bad. I literally went outside, walked from Fort William High Street back to Percy and was completely soaked. I'm still trying to dry out now. So I put the diesel heater on and I'm just sorting everything out because it's a little bit of a mess in here. I don't know how it gets messy so quickly, but it does, being in a small space, I guess. But yeah, I had a beautiful drive over. I didn't really see much, so I can't really call it beautiful. It still was really lovely though, and I've passed a lot of it before, on foot and in Percy last year. So I know what a lot of it looks like when it's nice conditions, but yeah, there's loads of Mon roads and things I want to do in that area, and I just couldn't do it in the Kintail, Shield Bridge area. Just the weather's been awful. It's been clagged out so bad. The rain's been awful. So it's just been a travelling day and getting lots of miles in. And like I said, I'm in Fort William now. There is a turn off and you can go to Fort William or Inverness. And obviously going to Inverness, we've finished my North Coast 500 trip. But I've been there and I've done the road to Inverness and I need to get back down south for some brown work. So I've decided to fork off to Fort William and I've just spent a couple of hours there getting some bits and bobs and also sat in Spoons for a little while as I've just booked something for this August and I'm extremely nervous. It's probably one of the biggest adventures I've ever done. So I'm at that point where I'm very, very nervous, but very, very excited. And I've got so much work and training to do to get to that point. So I've got now until August to be in top fitness, like peak fitness, and have everything down, like kit dialed in. And yeah, it's very nerve-wracking. You had to put down a bit of money to enter for your security, your safety, things like that. I'll tell you nearer the time, but yeah, that's why I need to come into Fort William. I wanted to get Wi-Fi to do that and actually sit with my MacBook and book on and do that. And yeah, it was a big move. I still haven't digested it, but I'm sure it'd be great. Yeah, the end of the trip, the end of the North Coast 500, the end of Isle of Skye. I'm really sad it's come to an end. It's gone so quickly. I don't know how I've spent a month up here. I think it's over a month actually in Scotland in itself. And it's just, it's flown by. Yeah, I think I've spent like 5-6 weeks up here and it's just flown by. It's scary how quick time goes. And I've seen so many beautiful sights when we go right back from the beginning. I started in this area and then I went over to the Cairngorms and then I started the North Coast 500 and I went up the east side, I went on the North Coast and then I dropped down, did the West Coast and then obviously just finished Skye. And it's been beautiful. It's been really beautiful. And I just want to thank everyone for supporting me to allow me to do that amazing trip. And I really, really hoped you enjoyed the video series. This is probably the last one, I'm guessing. I just really hope you enjoyed it. And this will be the final wrap up of my North Coast 500 series. And thank you so much if you've watched them all. If you haven't already, go back and watch them. It would mean a lot. And I'm really excited to reveal what else I've got coming up this year. It's really exciting and I'm just trying to make it the best year as possible. I really, really want it to be a good year and I want it to be full of happy memories, brilliant people. Good morning! It is my final day filming and I've just come to wrap the video up. So I've spent the last month in Scotland exploring all the nooks and crannies and exploring the North Coast 500 and the beautiful areas in between. It has been absolutely beautiful. I've had divine weather and I've learned so much on this trip. It's been really, really wholesome. I'm going to be spending the next few days in Glencoe
I'm on my way to do a swim in the sea, which is going to be very cold, with a couple of friends here in Glencoe, and then I'll be heading down to the lakes for a week, etc. So I won't be filming for a little while because I've been filming every day for 3 weeks. So I'm going to have a little bit of a break and get some editing done, catch up on editing, because I've got a whole lot of videos to edit and put on here for you guys. So I won't be filming for the next week or so. But thank you so, so much for watching this video. I really hope you enjoyed it. I've loved my time up here. Isle of Skye was incredible. So thanks again for watching. Thank you to all my wonderful Patreons for making this possible, who are listed in the description. Take care and see you on the next video.